to talk about this now, especially about community spread, is Kelvin Esemomo, respiratory therapist from the University of Wisconsin-Madison School of Medicine, USA. He joins me via Skype. Good morning, and thank you for joining us on TVC Breakfast.
Good morning. How are you doing today?
Very well, thank you. Let's begin by understanding why there is so much spread, even across the countries, not just Nigeria, but across the world. We see so much effort being put in place, but when it comes to the issue of community spread, despite isolating social isolation and all of it, or social distancing, we still continue to see the rise in the number of cases, taking, for instance, Italy and Spain.
Well, to tell you the truth about Italy and Spain, that most people don't understand is this. In Italy, because I was watching something on a show in Italy, and they were interviewing a patient who just got tested, and she was freaking out because she said she's OCD. But one thing most people don't understand in Italy, Italians and Spanish people, they don't shake hands, they kiss on the cheek. And that's the best way to spread the virus. They don't shake hands. Italians never shake hands, they kiss on the cheek. So that's why it's spreading around. They're always kissing the cheek. Like I made a point one time, there was a match going on, I think Atlanta was playing. There were like 92,000 people in the stadium. And each time, I think it was a Champions League, it was like a 4-1, I believe so. Each time they score a goal, everybody kissing the cheek. And that's the easiest way to spread the virus. That's why Spain, if you look at this, Spain and Italy, is very, very bad over there right now just because of the situation. And not only that, Spain and Italy have, when it comes to all elderly people, Spain and Italy, you have more elderly people in Spain and Italy.
But that is not the same when you talk about New York, where we see that is becoming also an epicenter, even the U.S.
Well, New York, you need to understand, we have a thing called Times Square Center, a bunch of people. So if you've ever been to Times Square Center, it's packed, filled up with people bumping each other. And again, there's a subway. Everybody, millions of New Yorkers go to the subway. A lot of New Yorkers don't even drive. My sister stays in New York. Most of them don't drive. 60% of New Yorkers don't drive. They just go to the subway. That is why it's spreading so bad in New York, because of the subway. And if you talk about foreigners, any foreigners you ask where do you want to come in America, the first thing they tell you, I want to go to New York. I want to go to Madison Square Garden. I want to go to Times Square.
All right, let's look at the use of face masks and gloves, which is also some of the measures being put in place. There has been some controversy being generated with regards to who has to use the face mask and when and why, and how to use the face mask as well as the gloves as well. At some point in Nigeria here, getting the face mask and even the gloves was an Herculean task. Talk to us by way of education, how best to use this and who should?
Well, the best thing about, well, I'll talk about the mask first. The main thing is this, like for us, we prefer whoever has like someone that has the COVID-19 or cough or cold, it's better for them to use the mask, because once they cough, it doesn't spread around. It's way better that way. But like I say, I don't judge people that still use the mask. But what I judge people are the ones that use the gloves. Gloves, I see a lot of people that use the gloves, but they still use their phone to text. That's the funny thing about it. I see it all the time. They wear the gloves. They touch everything with their gloves. Okay, they're still on their gloves, but they're touching everything. And once they get a phone, you see them texting. Then once they get a phone call, they put the phone on their ears and to receive the calls. And that's the easiest way to spread the virus too, because you've been touching stuff with that same glove. And at the same time, you're using your phone. So it doesn't really make sense. And about the face masks, when you put that mask on, people that put are always on face masks, you get to scratch all the time. You get to touch yourself because it's a little bit uncomfortable. So you touch yourself more than people without no mask, to be honest with you, because you're always touching yourself.
So how best can one use the gloves now? From what you have said, it seems because a lot of people feel safe by wearing the gloves. So how best can they use it?
Where you're not safe using the glove, to be honest with you. You're putting yourself in a bad situation using the gloves. It's better not to use the gloves. At least you have your hand sanitizer. You can sanitize your hand, put your phone in your pocket. When you get a call, you put your hand sanitizer on your hand. rub your hand and pick the cord. It's way better that way, because those gloves, because when you have that gloves in your hand, you feel that you're untouchable, you're invincible, you're good, and you get caught up with it. And you start using your phone, touching stuff, but the same cell phone that you use goes straight to your mouth and goes straight to your ears, and you talk to people. It doesn't really make sense. I think I always advise people at the hospital, mostly we don't use gloves, except we go to see a patient. That's when we're on gloves. But when we step out to take out the gloves and we use our hand, we clean our hand, we sanitize our hand, and we sit and we put our hands in the pockets. When we're walking, your hand is inside the pocket, or you just grab something, hold your shirt or something, just put your hand in the pocket. Don't touch the wall. Use your elbow to open the door.
All right, Dr. Kevin Eshemomo, thank you for speaking with us.